Wow, y'all coming in here early. Hey. Happy Sunday night. Happy Sunday night. Hey, guys. Happy Sunday night. Hey, blissful you. So I went to Home Goods today, y'all, and I purchased another ring light. For some of you, you know that my other stand broke. So we went to Target and I bought this one, and it sucks. It was $40 and I don't like it. So I'm going to return this one because it's so tiny. So I went to Home Goods, and to my surprise, they had a ring light with a phone holder. So I'm going to set that up in a little bit and hopefully it works good. But tonight, sorry it took me so long to get on live. Today was a busy day. We had orders being packed and we were just out and about running errands. So I'm sorry it took so long for me to come on, but we are going to sublimate a mug. For those of you who are just now joining, thank you for coming on. I did wanted to let you guys know that the pre-order for the Sublimation Youth shirts and the Sublimation Adult shirts are on the website live now. So if you head over to PeachtreeMarketCo.com and you're wanting to purchase a couple of Sublimation shirts and not purchase the Sublimation Starter Kit, then you can buy just single shirts so that way you can practice. So the difference is the Sublimation T-shirt starter kit comes with 200% polyester shirts and one bleachable shirt and four Sublimation transfers. But we are also on the website. You can also buy one shirt or as many as you need. It's a pre-order. Once we get all of the orders in, we will then ship them out. So those are on the website live today. And what else we're going to do today, we are going to make an Easter mug. So we are going to learn how to sublimate a mug together. I wanted to teach you guys some sublimation tips that you don't know, and then some sublimation things that you want to learn. So I was thinking a good idea is mugs. I love mugs. I started off doing mugs probably when I was around 18, 19, and I was doing vinyl on mugs, and that never lasted. So when I started sublimation, it was a great thing for me to start. And I love doing mugs. I love doing Starbucks cups and things like that. So, I wanted to teach everyone how to sublimate a mug. So we'll be doing a mug that we just added to our shop today. It is the Easter Bunny with the glasses. We're going to be doing that on a mug today or this evening. Hey, Jessica. Hey, God's Daughter 75. I'm doing great. How about you? Who else got messed up by the time change today? I knew it was coming, but I didn't think it would hit me as hard as it did. I was very taken back by it. Anybody else got messed up from the time change? I did, for sure. I was really taken back by it. I was doing orders, printing orders, and I look up and it said, like, 12:58. So I was like, oh, I'm making good time. And then I looked back up at the clock and it said 2. And I said, there's no way I've been in the room for 2 hours when I just woke up. It was crazy. I was so upset because I felt like I was so slow and just going behind on orders. So I'm happy that I wasn't the only one that got messed up by that. The ink may smear because the substrate is too hot. So when you're taking off the transfer and you don't rip it off like a Band-Aid, that is kind of like a ghosting. So that can happen if you don't rip it off right away. It can come sometimes smear on your substrate. Now, if you're talking about it smearing on the actual paper when it prints out, then that could be a problem with your ink lines, and you might want to run a couple head cleanings. I want to start doing sublimation shirts. I bought my heat press today. Awesome, Jessica. We do offer the sublimation t-shirt starter kit. So that starter kit has 4 sublimation transfers, full size transfers, and then it has 2 100% polyester shirts and then 1 bleachable shirt and instructions on how to do everything. But if you don't want the t-shirt starter kit, we are now offering just the 1 shirt or as many as you're wanting for sublimation. So we offer the youth sizes and we also offer the adult sizes. And the adult sizes are running to 2X, so we do have them. They're running to 2X. So if you're needing sublimation shirts, these are 100% polyester shirts. If you're needing them, head over to the website and you guys can purchase them when taking off the paper after sublimating. So that could just mean that your substrate is hot and you're not taking it off fast enough. So when I say that you have to rip it off like a Band-Aid, you really do have to rip it off like a Band-Aid. If not, it could prevent shifting and ghosting. And that is what caused the effect of a smeared look or a ghosting effect, if that makes sense. Yes, I have it in my cart. Just didn't get the courage to buy it. Oh, well, please purchase. Please purchase. The code TikTok will give you 10% off. So hopefully that gives you some incentive to purchase. Okay, so we are going to be doing a mug. So before we get started, I wanted to ask, what mugs are you guys wanting to do? Do you want to do 11 ounce or do you want to do 15 ounce? I have both, so I want to see which ones you guys want to do. I'm thinking 15 ounce because I love a bigger mug. Oh, Mona, well, today I'm going to show you how to sublimate a mug. So 15 ounce. Okay, 15 ounce it is. Let me go get one and then I'll show you how to start the process, okay? And again, sorry for coming on a little late tonight. We were thrown off by the time change. Like, it was a crazy day for us. So I'm happy to be on live and showing you guys a little something here, okay? Let me go get the mug and then we'll do it. Okay, so this is the 15 ounce mug. Awesome, I need to go work out, girl. My birthday's coming up and on April 3rd and I promised myself I was gonna lose a little weight before my birthday and that didn't happen. So work out for me, okay? So this is the 15 ounce mug. We do offer these in the shop. So if you're wanting to purchase sublimation blanks for mugs, we do offer these in our shop. As you can tell, it is a pretty big mug. It's a 15 ounce mug and they sublimate great. So we're gonna show that today. So the first step, I'm going to turn on our heat press. So let me go get the heat press, the mug press, excuse me, heated up. So the mug press has to get heated up to 400 degrees. And the mug press I have was $100. It sublimates 11 ounce, 15 ounce tumblers, 15 ounce campers. But from a lot of you guys, I've heard that it is sold out. So this is my mug press. If you guys can see it. And we're gonna flip it on so it can start heating up. I purchased this from Amazon. It's from the company Better Sub. And the funny thing is that Better Sub is actually a Chinese supplier that I know on Alibaba. But he advised that I could purchase some of their items off of Amazon. So he directed me to Amazon and I purchased it. Now, if you go check the link in my bio, it could still be sold out. I'm not sure. When I posted the link, everyone purchased, so I'm not sure if it's still there. But I do have an alternative if you guys are interested. So the first thing we're gonna do is print out our design. We're gonna be doing the leopard bunny with glasses today since Easter's coming up. So the great thing about Easter is that you can be fun with it or you can be kid with it. It's just on the line. And I thought that would be a great basket stuffer. So I've added it to the shop. So if you guys are interested in just purchasing the regular sublimated mug already made, we do offer those as well. So I'm going to show you guys the first step on sublimating a mug, and that is to print out your design. So for those of you who have joined my lives before, you guys know that I love to use Silhouette Studio. Silhouette Studio is free. So Cricut, I don't know if a lot of you use sublimation and you are using Cricut, but Cricut has already come out saying that in the next couple months, I'm not sure the exact date, but you can only upload 20 designs if you don't have the paid membership. So a lot of people are going to be switching over to Silhouette Studio. So this is the perfect opportunity if you are not going to pay for the paid membership to learn Silhouette Studio, so that way you guys can understand how to do the things that you would normally do in Cricut Design Space, but in Silhouette Studio. And I promise you, I'm a Cricut user myself. I have two. So I was hurt by the fact that they decided to not allow us to upload designs more than 20, but Silhouette Studio is very easy to learn, especially if you're just printing. So I think you guys should just download it, practice. There's no need to rush. Just learn how to do it. And I promise you, it's very, very easy. I learned it in a matter of a couple days. So I think it's going to be very easy for you guys to grasp. So I'm going to show you how I design and what we do. So let me get my computer up and running. Okay. So I'm going to flip you guys so you guys can see me over here. And I'm going to flip the camera. Okay. So we are in Silhouette Studio. And I'm going to go to my 8.5 by 11 sheet. So the size of paper that we're going to put on the mat is 8.5 by 11. Okay. I'm going to delete these designs because we're not going to be using these. These are something that I did earlier today. So the first thing I like to do is go to print page setup. And I pick the printer that I'm going to use. So 2720 is the printer I'm going to use today. And you are going to put it to US letter. US letter is 8.5 by 11. Click OK. So now we are all set up. Now, do you make sublimation transfers for copy mugs to buy? Yes. If you head to peachtreemarketco.com, we have over 130 sublimation transfers ready to press for you to pick from. And the 3-inch, the ones that you need for coffee mugs, are $1. Where did you get it? Oh, I already answered that. Okay. So for the coffee mug, you can do both sides or you can just do one side. Typically, you're welcome. Typically for my mugs, I just like to do one side. I know some people that like two sides, but I just like to do one side. So today we're going to be doing one side, and I'm going to make my design 3.5 by 3.5. So I'm going to show you guys how I size it for the mug, okay? So here is a box. How to draw the box, I'm going to delete it and show you. You're going to come over here to this little rectangle, drawing tools, click it, and then you're going to be able to draw a rectangle or a square. Now it doesn't matter what you draw it as, the height or the width, it doesn't matter. So now that we have it drawn out, I'm going to change the width and the height to 3.5 to 3.5. Okay, and now I have my box. So we are going to upload the design. We're going to be doing the leopard bunny. So let me see, I think it's under bunny. Here it is. So bunny glasses. This is the one that we're going to be doing on the mug today. How cute is this design, you guys? Do you guys like this design? I love this. So, what we're going to do is, obviously this is not going to fit on a mug, right? So we need to size it down. But I want you to guys
to see the negative space around the design. So right now, as you can see, this design is clicked. It says it's 12 inch by 12 inch. But we know that this design here in the middle is not 12 inches. It can't be. Hey there. So there's a lot of negative space around the file, right? So what I like to do is use the box method and then just drag it to it's a little bit smaller, right? And then we're going to fit it in this box. So it's still not fit properly. So let's size it out just a little bit more. And I think that's good. Now, some people ask me why I don't do this. And I'm going to show you why. Look at that. It doesn't even look like the real image. To me, that is not appealing. Right? So we're just going to backspace and just make it to where it's vertical. The design is vertical. So we're going to do it vertical. We're not going to stretch it to where it's awkwardly. Can you show how you upload the design one more time? It went way too fast to see. Sure. So what you're going to do once you have your page open, you want to make sure that your page setup is set up to the page that you're printing for. So if you're using 8.5 by 11, you want to make sure that your settings look like this. Or, you know, you can change it to where it looks like 11 by 17. Or if you have 13 by 19, you can make it 13 by 19. But we're using 8.5 by 11. So to upload this, to upload the design, you're going to go to File and hit Merge. And all of your designs is going to pop up. And we can just pick one and then hit OK. And boom, there's your design. And that's how it goes. Super, super easy. So one more time, if you're trying to upload a design into Silhouette Studio, you're just going to go to File, Merge, find the file that you're looking for, and then boom, that's it. Super, super easy. All right, so we are going to be printing this out for the mug, and I'm going to put it right here in the middle. Now, I know I'm going to get asked why I'm putting it in the middle. It's because I'm not going to actually use an 8.5 by 11 sheet. I'm going to use a 4 by 6. So I'm going to put it 4 inches over, and it's going to print just this row. And I'll show you guys what I mean in just a moment. So two dope sisters, I want to show you how to mirror if you don't know how to mirror. So you're going to make sure that the file you want to mirror is clicked, okay? And then you're going to go to Object, and it's right under Mirror, and you're going to click Flip Horizontally. And there you go. Now it's mirrored. And what we're going to do is duplicate it. So if you want to duplicate your design and you're wanting to print multiple of the same file on the same sheet of paper, on the same piece of sublimation paper, then you'll just make sure that it's clicked. And there's a little button up here, and it says Duplicate. And you just hit it. And now the design is duplicated. Very easy. Any questions before we move to the printer? Any questions before we move over to the printer? Any questions about Silhouette Studio? No? Okay. Now let's move over to the printer. So, we're moving over to the printer. So we are going to be using the 2720. He is such a cute bunny. Okay. So what I was saying is that the reason I didn't make the whole design fit that 8.5, 8 and 11 page is because I'm going to be using this size of paper. So this is a 4 by 6. And this is called mug paper. And it's made for mugs. So if you're wanting to do a full bleed on the mug, you will print this full of your design, and then you'll have a full bleed on your mug because it fits your mug perfectly. But I just use it to print out a couple of designs so that way I don't waste paper. So what I'm going to do is just load it into the printer and move my clips
So that way it's directly in the middle. And then we're going to hit print. And now it's printing. Aw, awesome. Do you have a video of sublimation settings? I have a E2720 and MacBook Pro. So the reason I don't have a video is because everyone's ink is different. I use Cosmos ink. So for Cosmos ink, you have an ICC profile. If you have Cosmos ink, then you can just DM me and I can help you. But some people don't have Cosmos, so that's why I didn't want to make a video, because you won't be able to get the same ICC profile as I have. Where do you buy the paper? You can purchase it off of Amazon, and it's literally just called mug sublimation paper. As you see, I only have a couple sheets left, but it's very affordable. You get 110 sheets for like $7. Very cheap. Very, very cheap. Now, it's smarter to use this paper than use this paper, right? Why would I put that little design up here and waste this good sheet of paper, right? No, it's not. No, Loda Crafts. You gotta do it. Because of your positive influence, I bought my 15,000. Yay, I'm so excited. So this is why I use the mug paper, because it's much more smaller, right? To print a 3-inch design instead of using this big piece of paper. So you don't want to waste, right? Sublimation paper is expensive. At least the brand I use. So I use Candy Custom Creations. I love your name. I use Tex Print R. And the mug paper is Tex Print R. And this is for the mug paper. So I have the mug paper, which is 4x6. And then I have 8.5x11. I have 11x17. And then I have 13x19. So I use all sizes of the paper. My goal is to have it open this week while we're on spring break. Sounds good. If you need help, let me know. So it's almost finished printing. I know y'all see my heat tape. I got so much heat tape. We're almost done with it. Okie dokie. So there we go. You see, two designs fit perfectly on the paper. So I didn't have to use the big, big piece of paper for just this little tiny design. Right? It's a 4x6. And I just want you to see that color. Now, this is the color before it's even pressed. This is how it's printed. Look at that color. Great color. Great, great color. Did you have to download the drivers? Yes. Whenever you're doing sublimation, you want to make sure you download your drivers specific to your printer, because you'll have advanced settings. What ink do I use? I use Cosmos ink. Okay, so now we are going to prep our mug. So a lot of people get confused when I say prep. They think I have to sand it or like do something like with epoxy or something like that. So with sublimation, whenever you're doing mugs, whenever you're doing tumblers, sippy cups, etc., you do not have to do any of that. So you don't have to spray paint, you don't have to sand. Sublimation is ready to go and you're good to go. You don't have to do any of that. Now, the one thing I do suggest when you're prepping your tumbler is you want to make sure you get a microfiber cloth. Okay? And this kind of looks like those eyeglass cloths. So you want to make sure you get one of these and just take it and then wipe off your mug or wipe off your tumbler, okay? You want to wipe them down. And the reason I say that is because there could be little bits of hair, you know, maybe your hair, maybe lint, maybe dust, whatever it is, it could be on the mug. And you just want to wipe it down, because if you don't, That lint and that dust is going to turn blue when you press your mug. It doesn't even matter if it's underneath the sublimation design or regardless. They're on Amazon. And you just want to wipe it down. If you do not wipe it down and you get little blue spots, it's impossible to get off. It's impossible. It's 100% permanent. So you will not be able to get it off. So just wipe it down. Wipe off your mugs. Wipe off your tumblers. Wipe off your sippy cups, your baby bottles. Whatever it is, whatever substrate you're using, if it's a trinket like this, like a keychain or something, just wipe it down real quick. When it's a shirt, make sure you lint roll. If it's a white shirt, lint roll. You always want to just make sure you're getting that lint off, okay? So let me get my heat tape and let me just go back up and look at some stuff. Hey, Rachel. Where did you get your drivers? If you go MBM Simplicity, if you go to Epson's website and type in drivers, then after drivers, you'll type in the printer that you have and then it should pop up for you. I got the Cosmos Ink. What settings do you get yours to on your printer? Candy Custom Creations. If you head over to the Sublimation Co. Facebook group and type in ICC Profile, it should tell you how to download it for your computer. I started with printer stacks and sublimation paper. That's good, Versatile Mommy. What ink do I use? I use Cosmos Ink. Okay, so the next step. Do you have a YouTube channel? I need to remind all this. I do have a YouTube channel, but I haven't been uploading videos. So, I will be uploading videos, I promise, but it's just a lot, y'all. I'm doing it all by myself. But I will promise I will upload videos for y'all. No alcohol. No alcohol is needed. You just need a little microfiber cloth. That's it. No alcohol, no sandpaper, no spray paint. You know, it's not like epoxy tumbler, so you don't need to do any of that. All right, let me go get the heat tape. One second. Can you 30 ounce any with... I don't think you can. It just depends. Now, if you just want it like this design to be the middle of the tumbler, then yeah, of course. But if you wanted a full wrap, I think you might be better off using 11 by 17 paper. You are the best for sharing your tips and tricks. Thank you. You're the best for sharing your... Yes, thank you. So this is the little design that we're going to put on. And I'm going to cut these like this. Because I'm only going to use one. And you want to make sure you cut along the edge, but just leave enough room so that way you can peel it off. Okay? So I think that's fair. So I'm just cutting around. Cutting around. All right. Now I'm going to share with you guys my little trick on how to get the transfer on the mug. Okay, so bear with me. Let me show you. Where did you get the design at? I got it from Etsy. Mine won't transfer. What kind of cups are you using? You have to use sublimation mugs. So you can't go to Dollar Tree or Walmart and just buy any mug. They have to be coated for sublimation. Where did you get the design? Etsy. I'm trying to decide on the 2720 or the 15,000. I want to do the bigger cups as well. Okay, so Indie Sublimation Supply. I want to explain a little trick for the printers, right? So for the 2720, the 4600, the 37, whatever, all of those smaller ones that only print 8.5 by 14, those are great if you're only doing mugs, 20 ounce tumblers, baby clothes, just little things like phone cases, etc. And you could probably do small, medium, and large shirts. Now, if you're wanting to plan to do extra large, 2X, 3X, the bigger mugs, 30 ounce tumblers, etc., I would suggest getting the 15,000. So that way you don't have to worry about if the print is going to be bigger. So the 2720, it only prints 8.5 by 14. So it prints longer, not wider. So I would suggest getting a larger format printer if that is something that you're wanting to do. Now with the 2720, if you wanted to do a 3X shirt and a 4X shirt, you could do it. You would just have to split the image in half and piece them together. But that's a lot of work, and I just did not want to do that. So I opted and got the $15,000 as well. So I use my $27,020 for smaller things, and then I use my $15,000 for bigger things. Okay, so little trick. Can you share where you purchase your cups from? We actually sell them as blanks on our website. So if you head over to Peachtree Market Co., you can purchase some. Okay, so we have our design here. And we have our mug. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, you're welcome. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take my transfer, okay? And I'm going to pull some tape off from my dispenser and place it right onto the mug, onto the so it's right on the transfer. Okay? So I taped it on to the transfer. Now I can take it and just place it onto my mug. I'm gonna line it up. There we go. Now it's on my mug. Now I don't have to like hold it in my lap. It makes it easier, right? So now here's the next trick. You're gonna take the mug, flip it upside down. This only works if you have a tape dispenser. If you don't have a tape dispenser, I'm sorry, I don't. You gotta use a tape dispenser. So the next trick is to hold it here at the base and take your tape and pull it directly onto the transfer. There you go. Now your transfer is taped down. That's it. Super easy, right? Instead of holding it and trying to wrestle with it, etc. Is that a good trick? Do you guys like that trick? So now the transfer is ready. So now the next thing we're going to do is, because we don't want the mug press to get stained or ink to bleed out onto our mug press, so I would suggest putting a piece of small butcher paper on top. So that way if any ink bleeds out, it doesn't get on your mug press. And if it gets on your mug press, you might have to buy a different foam pad for your mug press. So I suggest just putting a small piece of butcher paper so that way it doesn't bleed out. Okay, so let me go get a small piece of butcher paper and then we'll head over to the mug press. Okay, small piece of butcher paper. I'm just going to place it on top of the mug. Okay, over the design. Tiny little piece. Tiny little piece. Okay, so now we have our transfer and our butcher paper. Now we're ready to sublimate. So let's head over there. And I'm gonna show you guys the mug press. Here's the mug press. The mug press is heated up already to 400 degrees. Okay, so all you're going to do, Alexa, set a timer for 2 minutes and 45 seconds.
2 minutes and 45 seconds, starting now.
You're just going to slide it in, just like so. Then you're going to take your handle and just, there you go. It's in the mug press. The butcher paper, I got it from Sam's Club, and it was, about $22. So it's in the mug press. We're pressing at 400 degrees for 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Have you seen the Cricut mug press? Yes, and it's a total, complete waste of money. This mug press cost $100. I think it was less than that. I think it was $80. $80, $85. And it presses 11-ounce mug, 15-ounce mug, 15-ounce campers, tumblers. Is this the 15-ounce mug press? The only one I've seen is for 11-ounce. No. So this one, it advertises as 11-ounce and 15-ounce. I mean, it only advertises as 11-ounce. But I've tried it, and this is the one I have. This is a 15-ounce mug, and it actually fits in the cup holder. So 15-ounce, 11-ounce. 15-ounce campers, they all fit in the mug press. Candy Customs Creations, if you head over to our website, we actually sell them as blanks. And KMZ Creation, if you check the link in my bio, you can get the same one I have right here. I'm not sure if it's still in stock yet because it was sold out for a while. So Simply Sally, this one was advertised as an 11-ounce mug press, but I was like, let's just see if it's going to do 15-ounce and 15-ounce campers. And I bought it, and it does. So I was really happy. So we're just waiting. And it's really, really easy, y'all. Super easy. So if you want to buy the Cricut mug press, that's fine. But if you want to save some money, just go to Amazon and purchase one of these. Awesome. 11 ounces is just way too small. I need my big cups. Yeah, these are bigger cups. And I promise you, this is the same one that I have in the link in my bio. I linked it for y'all. And I'm doing a 15-ounce mug in this mug press. So let me take you off and then show you guys. So I'm doing the 15-ounce mug here. And it advertises as only 11 ounce. But I was like, it's only like $80. Let's just take a chance, you know? And I did, and it works. Okay, Alexa, stop. It's ready to be taken out. So let me take it out and show you guys. All right.
Sorry, I'm having trouble understanding right now. Please try a little later.
I have no idea what Alexa is talking about. All right. So can you guys see the bunny through the butcher paper? I haven't taken it off yet. Can you see the bunny through the butcher paper? This is why we use butcher paper. Okay? Because if not, this design would have been on my mug press and I wouldn't have been able to take it off. Look at that. You can already see that it transferred. Amazing. So now we're just going to rip it off. Hello. Ready, guys? What do you think? Tell me, what do you think? And look at the transfer. Hey there. Cute. Hello, can you put it on 11-ounce mugs? You sure can. Thank you. Super, super cute. I love it. Love it. Cute. Love it. Love it. Love it. Cute. Hi. So good. Really cute. Love it. Wow. It's beautiful. Thank you. What temperature did you press at? I pressed it at 400 degrees for 2.5 minutes. Cute. This is a 3.5. No, this is not a regular mug. This is a sublimation mug. And guys, for everyone that was scared, this is how easy it is to sublimate. Do not be scared by it. Do not be scared. How much do I sell them for? It just depends on the size. But probably with 10... maybe 14, 10 to 14. 2 minutes and 45 seconds, right? No, I did 2 minutes and 30 seconds. I just told Alexa that because it took me like 15 seconds to put it in the mug press because I was showing you. So just do like 2 minutes, 30 seconds. YinSid0916. It doesn't just work on ceramic. You can do glasses, like actual glass. You can also do steins. There's a whole bunch of different things, but this is a ceramic mug. Nice, I think I'll buy a mug press because I use the oven. Yeah, and that's exactly why, because if you guys see down here, I have an oven. But if I just want to do one mug, you know, like I just did, I don't want to have to turn on the oven and wait and then put it in and all that stuff. A mug press is much easier. So that's why I have both. I'm so mad about the Cricut mug press when I could have got yours. You can return it. Have you already used it? If you already used it, you can't return it. I don't think you can. But that's the transfer and that's the mug. Shrink paper. What do you mean for our website? On our website? With shipping? No. I never pay. If you guys are going to sell mugs, you want to make sure that you're charging shipping. Because if you don't, the mugs weigh about a pound. So you're going to have to come out of pocket for that. So always include shipping. What machine I need to start? What type of things are you trying to sublimate on? How much are mugs plain? It just depends on where you purchase them from. You can get them for just a couple bucks. We sell them on our website. Okay. So that's it, y'all. That is how easy it is to make a mug. Make shirts and cups. What size shirts are you trying to go to? I'm supposed to get my blanks order from you tomorrow. I'm super excited. I'm super excited for you. Show me how it comes in the mail. I can't wait to see it. Can you send me the link for the paper? Thanks. It's just in the link in my bio. So if you hit the link in my bio, you'll see the paper that I buy off of Amazon. This is a 15-ounce mug. Definitely wouldn't buy the Cricut mug press. Exactly. What size shirts are you, and mugs are you trying to make? Okay. So, for all my 34 people that are in here, do you guys want to make one more mug? Or do you guys feel like you got the hang of it? I just did my first cups and it looks burned on the sides. So that means you put it in for too long. So a good 15 size. What's a 15 size? Can you tell me in US sizes, like extra large, 2X? One more, please. I want to see the settings in your printer. So my settings are going to be tailored to my ink. Do you use Cosmos ink? If not, it will not work for you. When are you guys having the magic mugs, sublimation mugs? We are getting them in. Once they come in, I promise I'll do another tutorial. Do you have Cosmos ink in your Adriana's boutique? You do? Okay, I'll show you. Sure, would love one more cup. One more cup. I want to see the settings. One more, please. One more 15 size on a shirt. Everybody's saying one more cup. All right, so on larger or medium, then I would probably go with the 2720. I should know something by the end of this coming week when they're going to get here. And I don't, for mugs and stuff like that, then I typically don't do pre-orders. You can just order because I like to have them in hand. I should know something this week when we're going to get them. One more, please. On larger medium, if you're going to do larger medium shirts, you'll probably get away with getting the 2720. And that one's about 200 USD. But if you're wanting to do 3X shirts, 4X shirts, bigger projects, bigger blankets, bigger pillows, then get the 15,000. Okay, so let me go get another cup and you guys can pick the design that is going to go on the cup. Okay, you guys know how this works. We make something and the next person that orders will get the mug in their order, unless you're ordering sublimation transfers. So if you just order sublimation transfers,
We will not add it to the order because it's going to cost more. So if you're wanting the mug, just order something like shirts or something like that. So we're going to do the mug. Let me go get one and then we'll go do one together. So pick a design. Tell me what design you want. It has to be a design that's already in my shop, so that way I don't have to purchase any designs. But let me know what you guys want. Do you want St. Patrick's Day? Do you want Easter? Do you want funny? Do you want provocative? Do you want vulgar language? What do you want? We can do cuss words. We can do whatever you guys want. So let me know what you want, and we'll put it on the mug. And we'll do one more. Anybody that purchased Easter, you want to do another Easter? Another Easter? Okay. Do you want to do, I'm going to pull them up. So let me go get the mug and turn back on the mug press. Easter mug. We're going to do another 15 ounce. Easter. Easter bunny. Okay. So, perfect timing because I just purchased mugs today and I'm not sure how to use my mug press. Well, thank you for joining. All right. Let's see what Easter designs I have, y'all. And then I will show you what we can do. Let me put my password in. I don't want y'all to see my password. Okay. So, yes, the 15 ounce mugs are on our page. Hello. Love your coaster. Oh, thank you. I made them. This was one of the first things I made. This is me and my husband. So I just use them as my little coaster. Wine cups, yes, but a little different sizes. Does it matter what paper you use on different materials, shirts, tumblers? Just use sublimation paper. Okay, so you guys want Easter. What kind of coaster? These are the neoprene coasters, and we sell these as blanks in our shop. Sorry that it's a little dirty, but they're neoprene, so that you can fold them, you can wash them. We sell those in our shop. Okay, so you guys want Easter. So I'm going to show you the Easter designs that I have already. So okay, so I have this one. We already did a shirt with this design, but we could do a mug if you want. The Easter Gnomies. Then we have Easter. Let me see. Happy. I have this one. We have this one. Do you guys like that one? Or we could do this one, another leopard. And we did a tote bag on live the other day. So I have this one, the Happy Easter with the bunny, and it says Happy Easter. The Happy Easter Gnomies or the Happy Easter, this one. So you tell me which one and we'll do it. The three Easter bunnies. Trio. Three bunnies. Okay, we'll do the three bunnies. So let's get it started. You guys already know. Let me go get my charger. Give me 1 second. Happy Easter, leopard. Strickland, too close. We already picked the three Easter. I'm sorry. Everybody picked three Easter. So let's print it out. So I'm going to show you how to size it, and then we'll do it like that. I'll delete everything. I got it from Etsy, Crafting with Jess from Etsy. So I'll delete it and then I'll show you. Can you do a coaster one so we can see it? I know, dang it. maybe if we have time. Let me go get my charger. I'll be right back. Okay, so let's print it out. I'm going to show you guys how we print it. So for those of you who have been on live, you guys know that I use Silhouette Studio to print my designs. Okay. Yay. Thank you, Miss J. Okay, so if you're wanting to open a file in Silhouette Studio, you want to go to File and then Merge. Okay, all of your downloads are going to pop up. I'm going to pick the bunny that we picked. You guys said Happy Easter. Oh, and I said whoever ordered next would get Miss J, you will get the mug. So we have two mugs. You just ordered mugs. Okay. So Miss J, you're going to get, which one do you want? Do you want the Easter Bunny or the Easter Bunny Trio? You tell me. We made two, so you let me know. So for, let me do that again so that way you guys can see. I just realized she ordered. Sorry, y'all. Trio? Okay. Trio is yours. So for the next person that orders, we'll get the leopard bunny that we made earlier. So the next person that orders will get that mug in their order. So Happy Easter. Here's the Easter. Now we're going to size it down because we need a 3.5 by 3.5. You just put in my order. Okay. And yours is 48. Let me know if your order is 48, because if you're 48, then I will give you the leopard print bunny. Okay, so here's the design. We need it to fit a 3.5 by 3.5. So I just go to take my cursor and just size it down. Until it fits. Maybe just a tad bit smaller, but I think that looks good because it's, since it's horizontal and not vertical, then we want to make sure that it, this part fits within that 3.5 marker. If not, and it's wider, it's going to go off the cup. I'm using Silhouette Studio. So for me, Kooky Mom Designs, I use 3.5 on my 11 ounce and my 15 ounce. All right, so here is the design. Definitely Crafting with Jess, try to use it. It's really, really easy, I promise you. I am a design space person. I had bought 3 Crickets and then I sold one and I had to figure out something to do besides Cricut Design Space because it only lets you print a certain size. So I learned this program within a couple of days. It's super, super easy, I promise you. So here's the design. To mirror, you're just going to go to Object, Mirror, and Flip. And that's it. So now it's flipped. And now we need to rotate it so that way it fits on our 4x6 paper. So we're going to rotate it. That way it can fit on our paper. Okay. So let's print it out. Okay, okay. Yes, you have to mirror every time with sublimation. Okay. So we're going to use our 2720 again. You're welcome. And I'm going to use some mug paper. Yep, I'm using mug size paper for the design, 3.5 by 3.5. I didn't know there was a 4x6 paper. Yes, it is. And it helps preventing waste, right? Because this design is so small, we could just use half of it and use the other half later. So we're going to slide this in. And I'm going to show you guys, if you use scissor easy sublimation, you don't have to mirror. So 3.5, right? Yes, 3.5. So you guys are wanting to see my print settings. So here they are. So this is going to be your first sheet. Yeah. So this is for the first sheet, okay? This is under layout. I use Kooky Mom Tex Printar. Next, you're going to go into color matching. I use Epson Color Control. Paper handling, nothing. Cover page, nothing. Print settings. Paper source, auto select. Media type, presentation paper matte. Print quality, best quality. Now, some people like to check this box for mirror. I don't. I just automatically mirror them myself because if I check mirror image, when I print it out and I've already mirrored, it's going to be facing the wrong way. So I don't check this box, but you can check this box if you are going to forget to mirror. I don't. Next is color options. I do off, no color adjustment. Yeah, so this is the print settings that I use for both of my printers. I'm using the Epson 2720 right now. So color options, I put off. And then the rest, I think you don't need anything else. So that's really it. Print settings and color options. It's Tex Printar. I'm going to show you in just a second. Just a second. Tex Printar. I'll show you in just 1 second. I don't have a tutorial. Can I make a Tim room? What is a Tim room? I've never heard of that. So what you guys really just want to remember is you want to make sure that you're using photo matte paper. So presentation photo matte paper, because that's going to slow down your printing. And then the best quality. So those are the two main things. Okay. So now we're going to hit print. So now it's going to print to our 2720. So as you know, we both have, I have the 2720 and then I have the 15,000. The 15,000 prints 8.5 by 11. It also prints 13 up to 13 by 19. So if I wanted to use the mug paper in my 15,000, I could have used the mug paper in it, but I chose not to. I chose to do the 2720 today. So if I wanted to use the 15,000, I could have. I just chose not to. We're going to use the 2720 today. A lot of you are asking what paper I use. There is a link in my bio if you're wanting to use the same paper, but I use Tex Printar. Now, I do have to make a disclaimer. This is the most expensive paper. The reason I use the paper is because I sell sublimation transfers. So I want to give my customers the best quality when they're buying sublimation transfers. If you do not want to buy an expensive paper, then you can use ASUB, Crafting Besties. There's a whole bunch of others out there, But I have did my own testing. I have bought all of the papers, tried them out, and unfortunately, I didn't like any of them but this one. So this is what I use due to the quality that I like to bring my customers, but you can choose whatever you like. This is just my personal opinion from my personal testing, okay? So what I did was I bought all of the different brands, Koala Paper, Crafting Besties, Texprintar, a couple others, and I didn't like any of them. And I tested them all out, and this was the winner. So I suggest you guys doing that. If you would like to get, you know, samples of the paper, you definitely can ask the supplier. They'll send you like a 5-pack, and you can get free samples of the paper before you, you know, buy it. So this is why I chose this paper. Second favorite would probably be A-Sub, but this is my number one, okay? This is the most expensive, so I just wanted to forewarn you before you purchase. This is the most expensive that I've seen so far, okay? All right. So the design is printed out. Colors look amazing, right? I do not like Koala. The ink release was not enough for me. Okay. So I'm going to show you guys how to put it on the mug. So who can tell me the first step when you're sublimating a mug after you printed out your design? What is the first step you want to do with the mug? Clean it. Great. You guys already see. So you just want to take a microfiber cloth and wipe it down. You just want to clean it just so that way there is none of dust, particles, nothing. You don't want to clean it with alcohol. I've tried it and I just didn't like the effects of the alcohol on the sublimation poly coat. So that is up to you, but I just wipe it down with the microfiber cloth. I do not clean it with alcohol. Just take a cloth. Pick up all the lint, all the dirt. Okay? Now, here's the next. Do you do this for tumblers? Yes. So for tumblers, for anything, ceramic, metal keychains, any of that stuff, phone cases, etc., like trinkets like that, you want to make sure you wipe it down with a cloth. And then for like your coasters, your mouse pads, your shirts, anything that has like a fabric cloth, you want to make sure you lint roll. Okay. So now we're going to take our design and we're just going to cut. Okay. Show you. We're just going to cut. Do you have a video on how to sublimate on your shot glasses? I purchased those too. We did a shot glass a couple lives ago. What I can do, if you join my Facebook group, I can download the video and post it to Facebook because it's so long, but I do have a video on how to do it. We made two on our live a couple days ago. So now we have our design cut out. Okay, we've already wiped down our mug. So, mug trick, and this is on tumblers too. This works great on, you don't have Facebook things. Okay, I'm sorry. So, get a mug, get a tape dispenser. Very important for heat tape, get a tape dispenser. You don't wanna just hold it and try to pull it. I did that for like a couple months and it sucks. So, just get a tape dispenser, it will save your life. And then what you're going to do, because right now, if I try to tape this down, I'm going to have to try to hold it and then take the tape and put it on there. And like, it's just too much, right? So an easy way to do it is to put tape on one side. Okay. So you're going to pull your tape from your dispenser just enough
and then put the transfer underneath the tape. And there you go. So now you have one tape on one side. Now I'm going to take my mug and line it up. The best way to line up your mug is match the transfer up with the middle of the handle, okay, in between here. So I'm going to put the middle, the transfer in between the middle of the handles. Okay, now I'm just taping down that one side. Taped. Okay? You don't, sublimation prints dry. You don't have to wait for it to dry. So now I have one side taped, but I need the other side taped. So instead of picking the tape off of the dispenser and then trying to put it on the mug, just take the bottom of your mug, place it here, pull your tape off the dispenser, and just lay it on your mug. And now you have two sides taped. Okay? So how I've taped mine is side, and then up and down. And the reason you want to tape off the top, do you guys see that little hole right there? If I was to put that in my mug press, some ink could escape and I'll have a ghosting or it didn't press directly onto the mug. So always tape the bottom and the top, okay? So now we have the mug transfer taped. We're just going to take some tape and tape it down. Right? Flip it over. Boom. Taped up. Already ready. Okay? So, what is the next step? Now that we have our transfer tape down, what is the next step we need to do? Butcher paper, shrink wrap. You could use shrink wrap if you want to, but shrink wrap is so expensive and it's only one use. Butcher paper. You guys are getting it. Do you use your tape color transfers? No. It could be the brand you're using. If you want to use the kind that I use, the link is in my bio and I haven't had a problem with it. So just a little piece of butcher paper. And we're just going to cover the transfer. Take a little bit of tape. Tape it down. Okay. Now, everyone take note. Can you see the transfer through the butcher paper right now? No. Okay. So I'm going to show you why butcher paper is important. Okay. So let's head over to the mug press. We're headed over there now. Whoa. Okay, mug press is ready. This is the mug we made before. Now it's cooled down, so I will be shipping this off. To the two ladies that won, can you please drop your name below? I just want to make sure, and your order number. Just tell me your order number and the mug, because I want to make sure that you guys get it. If you could, just DM me. I just want to make sure I get the correct orders. So just let me know. Okay. So I'm going to tell Alexa to put on the timer for 2 minutes and 30 seconds. I'm going to tell her 2 minutes and 40 seconds so that way I have time to put it in the mug press and that way the countdown can start. So I'm going to tell her to put it on for 2 minutes and 10 seconds. 2 minutes and 40 seconds, and that way we can press it. So 2 minutes, 40 seconds. Okay? Alexa, can you put on a timer for 2 minutes and 40 seconds?
2 minutes and 40 seconds, starting now.
Okay?
So you're going to take your mug by the handle, slide it in, and then you're going to pull up the handle and close. There we go. Can you share where did you purchase your mug press? The link is in my bio. I got it for $80 and it's from Amazon. Not sure if I won. I'll go back over it. Let me see. And it's just sitting in the mug press. You can press tumblers. Yeah, you can press tumblers. I just prefer a convection oven for the tumblers. 400 degrees. I'm using sublimation mugs. Let me see.
Janie.
Okay. Janie gets the Tria. No, so this is a 15-ounce mug. On the link, it shows it's only for 11-ounce mugs, but this is a 15-ounce mug I'm doing. So it does do 11-ounce mugs, 15-ounce mugs, and 15-ounce campers. So it only advertises that way, but I vet it, and I promise you, no, this is just a mug press, not a 5-in-1. Order 1149. Janie, are you still in here? Does it have to be sublimation mugs for sublimation to occur? Yes. I don't know if I can go back up further. Okay, so you are getting the Trio. Great. You're getting the Trio, and then is it Edith? You're getting the leopard bunny. Alexa, stop. So now we're going to pull it down. I just purchased the Cricut one, but I'm not convinced. Yeah, definitely you spent a lot of money on it. So it's all done. $15.50. Yep, so you won, Edith. You won, Edith. You got this mug. You got this mug. All right. So, do you guys remember when I asked if you saw the design through the butcher paper? Can you see the design through the butcher paper now? Yeah. No, I'll show you what I use in just a second. You see the design through the butcher paper. So this is why I use butcher paper with everything I do. Because if not, this design would have been left on this platen. So the next mug I press is going to have this design. So it's important to use butcher paper, okay? So let's peel it off. Peel off time. Are you guys excited? Can you see the design through the transfer? That means we got a good release on our ink. I didn't even take the paper off yet. You can see what it says. Okay. Boom. Look at that, y'all. Kenia,
We sell them as blanks. I use sun for bleaching. Do you guys love it? And this is the transfer. If you go to peachtreemarketco.com, you can check out all the sublimation blanks we have. So there's the transfer. Right? And there's the transfer. So, good question. I got a question asking, can we reuse this? You can reuse it if you want to, but just note that it is going to be faded. Sorry, can you repeat it? It's peachtreemarketco.com. Do you use butcher paper for the tumblers as well when you put it in the convection oven? No. So, what I use for my tumblers is this. This is called silicone wrap, and it's heat resistant, so I wrap my mug in this really tightly, so it's reusable. Shrink wrap is expensive, and you can only use it once, so I don't use that. I don't use the masking tape method. I just use a silicone wrap. You can get these wraps off of Amazon. I have heard people can use them 2 times. You can... use them if you want. Just know it's going to be faded. The more you use it, the less ink is going to be in the transfer. Right? Yes, I use butcher paper for shirts. So, sorry about that. For everything that I use butcher paper. Everything I use butcher paper. Y'all, my light sucks. How does the wrap work? Meaning, how does it stay on the tumbler? Let me show you. I got a tumbler. I think. Let me show you. All right. So this is a 20-ounce tumbler that we have in this in stock, but they're not straight. Right. So these are just regular 20-ounce tumblers with the grip. You're going to take the tumbler. I like to have my husband help me, but you just take it and you pull it taut while you do it, and you just wrap it. Keep wrapping it, keep wrapping it. You know, of course you want to wrap it better than I did. And then you just put a little piece of heat tape, and there you go. Then when you're done, just wrap it off, take off the transfer, and you're good to go. So, the silicone wraps are on Amazon. And you can reuse it multiple times. So, instead of shrink wrap, you only use it once. Instead of masking tape, having to mask it all up and do all that, you can just reuse this. You want to use maybe one tumbler and get the technique down, because this is a technique in itself, but it saves you a lot of money. Okay, so I think we got... one more request to do a sublimation coaster. So we'll do a coaster. How much does it cost you, and how much do you sell them for? Yes, fun. How much does it, I don't know what you mean by how much does it cost me and how much do I sell it for. This thing scares me in the middle of the night, y'all. Yes, you can use the tumbler. You can use the mug press for straight tumblers, but for tumblers, I suggest the convection oven. This guy or girl, I got it from Hobby Lobby. It was $50 on sale. And it twists and it goes up and down. Do you have a list of materials and where you buy in your bio? I sure do. And if you do purchase off the links, it does give me a small commission. But everything I use in my shop, I've linked. So any questions on mugs, on sublimation, any questions? What convection oven do I have? I have the Oyster Extra Large. I bought it from Ollie's. I don't know if you have an Ollie's in your state, but we do down south. And basically, it's like an overstock store. And they sell everything really cheap. So the Oyster Extra Large, if you go to Walmart right now, they sell them in Walmart for like $150. I got mine for $50. How do you sell your, how much do you sell your mugs for? So for just mugs, design mugs, or for blank mugs? Because we sell them both. Oh, thank you so much. I have an Ollie's. Go to Ollie's and get your convection oven. And if the box is dinged up, call the manager and say, hey, can I get something taken off? And they will. Can the mug go in a convection oven? Good question. Do you know what you paid total to get started sublimating? So when I first began, I had the 2720, so that was $200. I had to buy paper, so I bought a whole bunch of paper. That was about $100 on paper. Blanks, say another $100. Software was free. Ink was $40. So for just the 2720, I would say $500, $500, $600. What did you sub your tumblers in the oven instead of mug press? Because mostly for tumblers, you're going to get a full bleed. A lot of people like full bleeds. So that's why you use the convection oven. So that way it sublimates the whole thing. If I put it in the mug press, it's not going to fit the whole thing. So you would have to do one part and then another part. What software do you use for sublimation? I use Silhouette Studio. Probably like $500 to start. That's where I'm at now. Yeah, about $500, $600. And then when I moved to the 15,000, I already had all my supplies and my blanks. So it was just an added cost of $600. That means it's on my wish list. Oh, so let me just tell you guys the difference. So I have a wish list and then I have what I shop for on Amazon. So what I shop for on Amazon is all of my things that I shop for. If you purchase off my wish list, that's going to be sent to me. The reason I have a wish list up is because my birthday's coming up. So I have some things that I wanted, especially for my business. So if you want to send me a birthday gift, you can. So there's two differences. One is a wish list and then one is a what I buy. How much did you sell your 20-ounce skinny subs for? For as blanks or as designed? I thought Silhouette was a free. Am I wrong? It is free. It is free. I don't pay anything for Silhouette. Nothing. So excited. Just purchased the mugs, wine, and coaster. Perfect. Thank you so much. Is it normal to invest money when I start a business? Because I spent a couple of money in equipment. Yeah, it's normal. You're going to have to invest to learn. It's normal to invest money when you're learning something. Now, there was a good question. Let me go back. Hold on a second. How many mugs do you think you've made with that press? With the press, probably like 200. This past December was crazy when it came to mugs because a lot of people wanted them designed with their family and all that stuff. So probably about 200 mugs so far. The convection oven, I probably did 200 plus with the convection oven. I don't see the mug press on your wish list. So wish list is everything I want, you guys. For, as a wish, you know, like something that you can purchase for me to buy because you want to help me out, or like what I buy for. There's two different links, so just make sure you read it on my bio. What do I buy? And then wish list is things you can buy for me. design mugs. Just take a look at my website. They just depend on this, on the different type of transfer that I use. So, is it the same process for the magic mug? Yes, it is. Same process for the magic mug. $650 to get started. Yeah, it's well worth it. It's really good investment if you plan on sticking with it. Now, if you're wanting to do this as a hobby, if you have that extra cash, by means, spend it. But if I'm just doing this as a hobby and I'm not selling anything, that's a steep price. So just make sure you know what you're getting into before you go and buy blanks, because blanks are expensive, right? And the sucky part with sublimation is that once you put a transfer on there and you mess it up, it's messed up. When I first started, I messed up so many mugs. I donated them to the Goodwill. They were so ugly. So ugly. I messed them up. There was lint everywhere. It was like blue specks on them. I didn't really know what I was doing. I was just trying. And eventually I got the hang of it. Waiting to get some items to come in, then love to set up a Zoom call with you. Yes, definitely set up a Zoom call. We do offer Zoom 101 classes. You're not wrong. Silhouette is free. So design mugs, just check out my website. For some mugs, I may charge $12. For some mugs, I may charge $15, $18. It just depends on the design and what I put into it. So don't go basing your designs and your method off of my prices. My prices are solely based on the cost it's for me and how much I make off of it. So do your own math. Do not go based off of what I sell it for. I charge for my labor. I charge for everything I use. So add up your stuff and then select your own pricing. Don't just go based off of mine, because my profit might not be your profit. You might want to get more or less, right? So they have to be sublimation mugs. You can't go to Dollar Tree and buy Dollar Tree mugs or like Walmart mugs or anything like that. They have to be sublimation mugs. Do you have the links for your printers? The links for my printers should be in the bio. A lot of them are sold out right now. A lot of people can't find the 15,000, but they should be in the bio. If you do epoxy cups, you can just use the mess ups for glitter ones. Oh, that's smart, but I don't do epoxy. Yeah, so remember that the 2720 has two different colors. They have a white and a black. It doesn't matter the color, it's still the same printer. They just chose to put one in black. I just got mine's white because it matches the decor in my room. See you tomorrow at 9. Mid-January, awesome. Okay, so I wanted to show you guys, if you don't want to invest in the mug press, then you could get one of these. Thank you, I appreciate your help. Could you do a live one day doing sublimation on a wine tumbler? I sure can. I download a silhouette, but I don't know how to use it. I promise you, you'll get the hang of it in just a couple days. You'll learn. And the great thing about Silhouette, it's been around for a long time. So if you have just a specific question like how to mirror an image, type it into Google and a video will pop up like that. I promise. There's so many tutorials out there. So let me show you guys. Is it easy to use Silhouette? Yes, very easy once you get the hang of it. I do try to go live every single day. How often do you go live? I try to go live every day. What size do you make your wine decals? It just depends. A lot of people can do full bleeds, but I don't know how. So I would have to measure it, but I'm not sure. All right, let me show you guys something real quick. Okay, so this is how you can sublimate. Usually around 4:30 Eastern Standard Time. That's usually when I go.
I do have a video, Crafty Nat, on subbing tumblers. You have to go to my Facebook page, though, and scroll. Try to find it or just search it. You're so welcome. So this is another way that you guys can sublimate sublimate mugs if you don't have a mug press. Okay. So this is a clamp, and I'm going to show you how it works, okay? What you do, you can get these off of Amazon. These are on Amazon. You just put your mug in the middle. Take it. And then clamp it. Boom. Covers the mug. And you can put this in the convection oven. So if you don't want to get a mug press, if you don't want to get the mug press, and you only want to use the convection oven, you can get one of these clamps off of Amazon. They come in ones, they come in threes, they come in 12s, but you can get these off of Amazon. And this is how I started sublimating mugs with these clamps. So if you're wanting sublimation clamps, they're on Amazon. And this is how you can start sublimating mugs in your oven. Instead of using shrink wrap, instead of using whatever you're using, tape, you can use these. And these are reusable. No, do not use the clamp in the mug press because there's no need for it. The mug is just going to go directly onto the platen. How long to heat with the silicone wrap? So this is only for convection ovens. And it just depends on the mugs that you buy. If you purchase from us, I would say about 6 minutes in the oven. Yes, always use butcher paper. Now the reason why, if you use butcher paper, is because say we have this in the mug. Do you see the design? The design is going to go to the silicone wrap. So the next time I use the silicone wrap, it's going to be on the wrap. So the next mug is going to have that design. So always, always use butcher paper. How much time do you put it in the oven? It just depends on the mugs you use. I would suggest 5, maybe 6 minutes. But you just put it in here like this, clamp it up. And you can do 3 mugs at a time in the oven. As long as you have a bigger oven, right? And then you just clamp it. And there you go. And it's tight. Can you put a tumbler in a mug press? You sure can. If it's a full bleed design, you're going to have to press it in sections. Can I see what is the paper you're talking to cover the design? Yes, it's called butcher paper. And you can buy it from Sam's Club. Get 1,000 feet for $22. And this is what I use. Okay, any more questions? Any more designs, questions, silhouettes, questions, printer questions? Any questions? You're welcome. I think someone asked if we could do a neoprene coaster. I think we'll do coasters tomorrow. It's a little late where I'm at. I'm getting a little sleepy. Thank you so much. You've been so helpful. You're so welcome. My ink lasts, I would say, a good 3-4 months. And I print every day. So one thing that you have to know is that eco tanks are built to last. So when you buy an eco tank printer for just regular printing, they advertise it as you can get 2,000 prints in just that one set of ink, right? That comes with the printer. So, or it lasts 2 years or something like that. So whenever you print with the eco tank, the lines are controlled. So that way it doesn't use as much ink and you get a lot of usage out of the ink. So it doesn't matter that it's sublimation ink. It's still going to register its ink, so you're not using a lot, right? So it just depends on how much you print. But with my 2720, when I first started, I didn't have to refill my ink for 6, 7 months, 8 months. And even when I refilled the ink, it was still like to the second line at the bottom. So it just depends on how much you're printing. I know some people that have to change their inks out every 2 months because they print so much. But it just depends on how much you print. But I print every day. It just depends on how much you print. So it lasts me about 3 months, probably tops. Can you do a coaster? I know someone wants me to do a coaster. Let me see. Hold on a second. How do you keep your craft room so clean? Mine's a mess. I am a neat freak when it comes to things. So after every day, before I leave my office, I clean up. So that's why no matter how tired I am, I put everything away because I cannot stand to come into a dirty craft room. That's just me. I'm like OCD. I think that's what it's called. Someone wants me to do a neoprene coaster. How about we make a deal? I'll do neoprene coasters tomorrow. Is that fair? I'm a little tired. Coaster. Oh, y'all are making me sleepy. When I downloaded Silhouette, it was slow. Is that normal? It shouldn't be slow. I'm in Georgia. You're welcome. Can you do a coaster? I've done puzzles. I don't like puzzles. Yes, I do A85Z1. I do have links if you check the link in my bio. If you buy a sublimation PNG for a Cricut, can you just send the image to print and then to a mug? I'm not sure what you mean. So once you buy a PNG file, you upload it and then print it out. There's no need to use your cutting machine, right? I use Silhouette Studio. Difference between EcoTank and Workforce. That's a good question. The difference between the EcoTanks is that they have tanks. The Workforce printers have cartridges. And those cartridges need updates. So that's why a lot of people don't like them, because they have a lot of errors and they have a lot of problems. Okay, coaster. Hold on. Let me see. Give me 1 second.
Let me see.
Okay, y'all want me to do a coaster. Next live. We're going to do it next live. It's 11 here, so I'm a little tired and my husband is already laying down. And I feel bad. So, I'm going to go live tomorrow. If I don't get on around 4:30 Eastern Standard Time, because I'm in Atlanta, then I would suggest coming around 6. But if you follow me, then it will pop up on your screen when I'm live. So just follow me. I should be coming on anywhere between like 4:30. That's when I like to get on. 4:30 between 5:30. So that's when I try to get on every day. But tomorrow, since you guys are wanting to know how to do the neoprene coasters, we will do neoprene coasters. We'll do 2. 2 coasters. So thank you for the winners who won the mugs. Now it's not hot. These are the mugs we did today, y'all. Super fun. Super fun. So happy that you guys learned how to do it. Do you have to print daily when having sub ink? No, you don't. I've left for a week to go on vacation pre-COVID, and it was fine. I came back and I just printed 1 page just to make sure it was fine, and it acted like I never left. So you don't have to, but I would suggest doing regular maintenance. So if you're not going to use it for weeks at a time, just go in for maybe 10 minutes, print out a test page, and that's it. How do you know what size to make a mug? So if you're doing just one design like this, and you're doing 11-ounce mugs or 15-ounce mugs, 3.5 by 3.5 is your go-to. If you're doing a full bleed, that's a different that's a different thing. One last question. Where do you buy your images? I buy my images from a lot of places. So I go to Design Bundles. That's number one. And the reason I say Design Bundles is number one is because Design Bundles, a lot of the sellers that are on Etsy are on Design Bundles. And the reason why is because Design Bundles doesn't take as much money from the sellers. So if you go to Design Bundles and see a design you like, head over to Etsy and you'll see it's a dollar more. So always check Design Bundles first and then Etsy as a last resort. I purchase a lot from Design Bundles, Etsy. I buy Lifetime Drives. So this is a big one. Lifetime Drives. I bought one from Getting Crafty With It. She uploads like every single day new designs, and it costs me $20 for her lifetime drive. So I access all of her designs for my lifetime or her lifetime for $20, and it's commercial usage. So look for lifetime drives, and look for bundle deals. So sometimes like 5 or 6 artists will collab and do a bundle deal for like $25, and you get like 50 designs for $20. It's a great deal. So I just bought one. If you head over to Halia Wood, that's one of my favorite designers. I love her PNGs. Head over to her, and she has like a bundle going on right now. You are so welcome. How did you come up with your logo name? So, for those of you who don't know, I do live in Atlanta, so we live in the Peach State, and I came up with ink. I came up with Peachtree Market Ink, and the reason I did ink was because I thought it was, like, cute. I don't know. I just thought it was a nice name, but then I was like, let me go with Co., because I was seeing, like, a lot of Co.'s, like, Creations Co. and all that, like, company. So I was like, I think that would be good. But the reason I chose Peachtree is because Peachtree is the Peach State and we live in Atlanta. And then I chose Market because let's say tomorrow I didn't want to sell anything sublimation anymore. I just didn't want to do sublimation. I can keep my name and sell coffee or sell groceries or sell shirts or sell pillows or whatever I want to do. Because at a market, you can sell whatever you want, right? When you go to the market, you can buy anything. So that's why I chose Market. So I don't think I'm going to ever give up sublimation, but you never know what a path has for you. So if I do decide to sell something else, I can. You're welcome. You're so welcome, y'all. So type in Getting Crafty With It. I don't know if she's still having her sale right now, but Getting Crafty With It. Kim Hunt, Winder, Georgia. Hey. How do you do the magic mug? Smart. Thank you so much. So the magic mug is the same way as a regular mug. You put the transfer on. It's black. So when you first have the mug, you wipe it down, put the transfer on, tape it, and then put it in your mug press or your convection oven. And while it heats up, the mug turns white. Thanks for the tips and showing us how to sub mugs. Can't wait to receive my order. Good night. How did you go from complete custom to just selling one shirt designs? I'm not sure what you mean. Complete custom to selling one shirt designs. I'm not sure what you mean by that. All right, guys, I'm about to head off. I'm getting a little sleepy here. I'm happy you guys love the designs. We will be packing orders tomorrow on live. And you guys are going to be here with me when we sub the neoprene coasters. Do I have a business background? I do not, but I have had 3 failed businesses. I wouldn't say failed. My last business, we did close to 4,000 sales on Etsy. And then the one before that, we did like a couple hundred. So I don't have a business background, but I have run a couple businesses. Where you sell one basic design versus every design being custom to a customer? I don't know what you mean. Like, what are you asking? Are you asking how do I put them on the shirt and then sell it to that broad audience, or have them pick designs? I'm confused by that, and I'm not sure it's because I don't understand or is it because I'm sleepy. Thank you. Yes. I spent a lot of time in this office crying, upset, frustrated because no one would help me. So everything I'm teaching you guys, I learned by myself. No one taught me. I taught myself. So that's why I'm confident in anything I teach you guys. And I'm not saying I know everything. I know a good way, right? I don't know everything, but I know what I know. Tomorrow, 4:30 Eastern Standard Time. That's the time I'm gonna try to get on. Awesome. Cool. All right, guys. Crafty Monkey by Diane. Can you let me know what you're talking about? I'm sorry. I really want to answer your question. I just don't know. Yeah, I feel like I spend a lot of time doing individual shirts for one client. Okay. So I just pick designs that I like. That's really what it is. I pick popular designs. Like, let's go back to Christmas, right? The one thing that was selling really crazy during Christmas time was there's some hoes in this house, right? With the Santa Claus. So I did a red hoodie with there's some hoes in this house. I bleached it and it was going crazy, right? So that was a broad design that everybody wanted at that time. But when I go to like pick designs for my mugs, like this mug is in my shop, I pick this design because I like it, right? I please the aesthetic, right, of my customers and knowing what they want, but I also pick things that I like and that I'm comfortable selling. So that's how I decipher what designs I want to pick and things like that. I go with I like, and then I also go what I know is going to fit the market and what can sell to your market. Because if you don't know what your market is, it's not going to sell. And I'm not going to lie to you and say that everything in my shop has sold, because it hasn't. There's been designs that I've had and someone just bought this year and it's been up for 2 years, you know? So you just have to gauge it and do what makes you feel comfortable. Right? So I'm comfortable selling things that have the word bitch in it. And, you know, I have vulgar designs. And I'm comfortable selling that because I know my market. But you may not be able to sell something that has the word bitch in it, or cuss words in it, or vulgar language in it because of your area or the people that buy from you. So just know your market and then know what makes you feel comfortable and what you like. Because there are some things that I just won't post in my shop. And there are some things that I will, right? Okay. Any more questions? We are jumping off. Thank you guys for everyone that purchased. I'm so happy for the winners of the mugs. I'm so happy you're getting these mugs. We did this just for you guys. We'll be on tomorrow around 4:30 Eastern Standard Time. And we're going to be doing neoprene coasters. I'm headed to go get some rest. You are so right. I hope you guys enjoy your night. And this time change screwed me up. I was fine when I woke up this morning and now I feel so tired. All right, guys, I'm headed off. I hope you guys come back tomorrow and we'll sublimate some more things tomorrow. Bye, guys. Good night.